Hi, my name is Freedom. Today I'm going to show you how to download any models from 3D Warehouse and import to your iClone. So first we look at the 3D Warehouse. You can search any models here. I search a car, C-A-R, enter. And we look at the result. Maybe I have something that I need. For example, I want this. Just to click on the picture and click see more details. Here you can check the 3D models and wait for a while. It is loading. So here I can see the 3D view. If I love it, then I download it. Click at the corner here. I download SketchUp 2017. The oldest format. The oldest format is always better. So just to click and wait for a while, it will download here. This one already downloaded in your computer, I just need to show in folder. This is an SKP file. I cut and paste it somewhere else. So I put on my desktop. I paste it here. This is the SKP file. The next step we are going to open. Open a new folder, demo, car download. I put in this folder. Because later, during the process of conversion, it will generate more and more files. So now once you download this, name it properly. Car demo, demo car 01. Okay, double click. You need to have this software, what we call the SketchUp. So in the SketchUp, you can edit it. You also can direct export it out. So I want to export it here. This is the first step. File, export, 3D models. Here I choose 3DS. I love to convert it to 3DS first. So export. Export at where? Don't export first. I copy this folder's location. Copy. Paste. Enter. Already in the folder, then export. Later, you will see all are here. Now it's on the converting process. Export to here. It takes some time. It depends on how complicated the 3D models is. So now already finished converting. It appears as a 3DS file. You may need to be able to see the file extension. If you cannot see the file extension, you just to come to the Explorer view, option, view, and make sure you untick the hide extension for known file type so that you can see all the file extension. By default, you can't see. So you need to untick it to see the file extension. So finish converting, you get the 3DS file. Go to your 3D Exchange. Drag in the 3DS file. Conversion also need to take some time. This is direct import. Okay, now done converting. It is too small. I can make it bigger. First, click Reset Transform. And I press R. Click on the yellow color. Then drag it. Become bigger. So this is just an indicator. You can turn on and turn off as a reference of how big is the size. Sometimes at here you have a little bit lag. After I click R, I have to wait for a few seconds to let it appear. So after adjust to a suitable size, click again Reset Transform, align to center, align to ground, Reset Transform again. Then, now it is ready to send to iClone. Just to click Apply to iClone. Then in the iClone, you just wait for a while until it finish loading. Okay, now it's in your iClone already. We just check the texture. Everything look okay. So now in iClone, you can save it as a prop. Just come here. Custom. Prop. And click Add. So now you already set as a prop. This one I name it Car. Demo Car 01. I can use it anytime as a prop. What I need to do is, I just need to drag it out. It is a prop. You already have this file. Okay. Okay. Already save. Actually, you already done this process. I don't want to save this project. So the next, I'm going to show you how to use the 3D warehouse. So you need this link. The rest I can delete it. This is the homepage, 3dwarehouse.sketchup.com. Enter. Search any model here. Building. Just try to search anything. Can download any 3D models here. Then can you use it? So here I have a link. This is the SketchUp 3D Warehouse. Okay. 3D Warehouse term of use. You can have a reference at here. So the term of use, general model license. You see the first one, license grant. This license to the model grant above is limited to all this. So can you use it? Yes, you can use it. Distributing models creation and combined work to third party for your business purpose, including commercial purpose. So can you use it? Yes. So in this term of use, you can read some of the important term of use. Yes, you can use the model for your own business, for your commercial purpose. If you are a professional designer, you have a project, download from the 3D warehouse, is it okay? Yes, you can use it. You may deliver the combined work that is the result for hire. Even if your combined work contains the model downloaded from 3D warehouse, yes, you can use it. In 3D animation, I think so. So I cannot give you any advice about this. Before you use it, you just refer to your legal advisor or refer to your lawyer. Here, we have unlimited models you can download anytime. Right click, open in a new page. Okay, you cannot open in this way. You need to click it first. Right click here, open in a new tab. Then here, close it. Then it will load into the page. Thank you for watching. If you feel all these tutorials are helpful to you, you can subscribe to my YouTube video.
Go to the bottom of the video and click subscribe. Click the bell to receive all the notifications for every time I publish a new video and tutorial if you love it. If you find it helpful, I will keep on post more and more tutorial for you.
Like it, she likes it.